So, what is CPU throttling? Well, in the everyday sense, throttling is the process of regulating the flow of something such as gas or liquid in a system or an engine. In other words, throttling means intentionally slowing down or speeding up of some flow. But, here in this case, we are talking about what is known as the CPU throttling. CPU throttling is the intentional lowering of the clock frequency of a CPU in some specific situations. This is done automatically by the operating system for mainly two reasons. 1. In order to save energy, and thus extend the battery life if it is in use. 2. In order to avoid the problems of overheating due to excessive heat generation by the system. The first condition for CPU throttling occurs when we're running some lightweight applications or programs, such as some news apps, or lightweight editors, etc., and not much else. In such a situation, we're not in need of the full available power and resources of our system, and so, if we slow the system down, there will be no negative impact on the user experience. Doing this saves energy and reduces heat generation whenever the system is idle and is particularly important with systems, such as phones, tablets and laptops running on battery power, since it extends the battery life. The second condition for CPU throttling occurs when excessive heat is generated by the system components, mainly by the CPU. When a complicated program with high workload runs for a long period of time, when we use our smartphone or any other device or a computer, its CPU, in addition to other components, is running and it is producing heat, and the amount of the heat it produces depends on the voltage, the CPU clock frequency and the chip design. The heat thus produced is passively dissipated through the chassis or body of the phone itself, or in case of any other type of computer such as a desktop or a laptop, it may use various active or dynamic cooling techniques such as the use of heat sinks, cooling fans, etc. Now when a heavy-duty program runs for a long period of time, the heat produced as a result may reach above the certain saturation level for dissipation, and the chip will start getting hotter and hotter to the potentially damaging levels. When the heat gets at that level, the operating system kernel will notice what's going on, and it will trigger the throttling process to bring down the amount of heat being produced by the CPU. It will bring down the clock rate frequency. It may even bring down some other things like the voltages so that the heat being produced by the CPU can be safely handled. When it senses that the CPU has cooled down enough and there is more room for additional heat production, it will ramp up the CPU back to the normal level. We should note that, when it throttles, it will actually bring down the performance of the machine, because we know that performance is directly related to the clock rate. The higher the clock rate, the more instructions a processor can execute. CPU throttling can also be triggered in some slightly different situations. For example, Apple has confirmed that its iOS operating system deliberately slows the processor speeds of iPhones as they get older and the batteries deteriorate, prompting anger from some who say Apple is just trying to trick customers into buying new devices.